This story begins the day after I moved into my new house. I had just moved from my apartment, which was in a bad neighborhood, with lots of bad things happening there. But that's a whole other story. So, I had just moved into my new house, a small two-bedroom house. The kitchen was right in front of the master bedroom, and the secondary bedroom was right off the living room. I had my mother and two siblings living with me. They took the very large master, while I took the secondary bedroom. Anyway, this encounter took place pretty late in the night, right around 11 p.m. Everybody had gone to sleep, so I was pretty excited that I got the house all to myself. I decided that I would do the dishes to help out my mother, then play some games on my Xbox for the rest of the night. I walked into the kitchen with my dog and started doing up the dishes. About halfway through them, I started feeling really uneasy. I started thinking that it was just an unexpected anxiety attack, which I get pretty often, so I didn't really think much of it. I paused, decided that maybe a glass of water would help. While I was sipping my water, I started to hear my dog growling from the living room. I say my dog, but he really is my mother's dog. He is a very, very good guard dog, as in will destroy an intruder in a heartbeat type of guard dog. So I hear him growling, a very low growl, a quiet growl. Me being the stupid 17-year-old who I am, I decided I was going to go see what he was doing. I put down my glass, walked into the living room, where both my puppy and mother's dog were standing by the front door, their nose in the crack of it. I tiptoed up my way to the door, listening very carefully. All I heard was a faint scratching noise. I assumed it was just a raccoon, or one of the stray cats that frequented our house, because we would always leave food for them. I took a peek out the front window, which is located right beside the door. Well, I didn't see anything. Just the dark yard and porch illuminated softly by the glow of the streetlight in the very front of the house. I told the dogs to chill out before they woke up the entire family. After they settled down a bit, I went back to finish up the dishes and think about what games I was going to play. As I was washing a plate, I got that uneasy feeling again. The feeling in the pit of your stomach that just feels like something is very wrong. I tried brushing it off, but it was coming on so strong. All of a sudden, I got the feeling as though somebody was behind me, staring at me, silently watching me. My uneasy feeling turned into scared, then stress. I was so uneasy that I whispered to myself, "Something bad is going to happen. I just know it." The floor began rumbling as though someone was running on it, running up behind me as my back was turned away from the entry to the kitchen. It rumbled so hard, the pounding of the footsteps was so loud. I didn't know what to do except put my hands over my ears to block out sound. It ran up behind me, and it slammed me into the kitchen counter, leaving a large purple bruise on my stomach. As soon as it all started, it stopped. Nothing but silence in the small kitchen. While checking my stomach, I waited, just to see if anything else was going to happen. But nothing did. The room fell quiet. I began panicking, feeling so scared about what had just happened. I finally got the courage to turn around, and as I did, I sighed in relief. My big-eyed pupper was sitting in the doorway, staring up at me. I walked over to her and hugged her, then hooked her up to a leash to take her out before I went to bed. At this point, it was about 12 p.m., and I was so scared and exhausted from that experience, I just decided it was the sleep my body was desperately craving but had not received, causing me to think something happened when it really did not. Though it doesn't explain the bruise forming on my stomach, I said to my pup, Hard to believe that my mind could conjure up something so scary. She was hooked up, and when we walked out on the porch. Normally, we have 4 baby stray cats that basically live out there, but they were nowhere in sight. I assumed they took cover at the neighbor's house. I walked little Pupper into the yard, a little ways from the side of the house where the kitchen window was. Now, I wasn't in front of the kitchen window. I was at the front of the yard, but I could see the kitchen window from where I was standing. I looked down and talked to my pup, telling her what a good girl she is and how beautiful she looked. You know, what all puppy mamas do. She looked up at me and wagged her tail in delight. But then her mood suddenly changed as then her neck snapped to where the kitchen window was. When I say snapped, I mean she turned her head so fast, I for real thought she was going to break her neck. It startled me, so I naturally took a couple steps backwards, trying to calm down from the scare. I glanced over to where she was looking, just a small quick glance, and to my surprise, I actually saw something. I wasn't expecting to see anything, so I had a double take at the sight of this thing. We both sat and stared, trying to see what it was. It looked like a tall black silhouette, maybe 8 feet tall, with a very large chest. I remember the chest so well, because it stuck out so far, like scarily far. The figure looked thin in the face, but quite large in the rest of the body. It was staring over the large hedge that was in front of our kitchen window. It was staring into the window, like it was waiting, silently, for somebody or something to move inside the house. I'm guessing my dog's eyes finally adjusted to the darkness, because she let out a small woof at this creature. As soon as she did this, the creature turned his head and stared at me with huge green eyes. My heart sank. The way its eyes were reflecting the light made me instantly think that what I was standing in front of was a giant 7 to 8 foot tall animal. It was silent. No sound. No nothing. In fact, I was so focused on the creature that I had failed to realize that the night insects had gone silent. There was no noise, except for the static sound of the energy coming from the city. I froze while my puppy began barking loudly and violently. What could this be? Am I seeing things? Is this real? I scooped my pup in my arms, ran in the house. All the while, the same pounding and hearing the loud thudding footsteps as the previous encounter that took place an hour earlier. I ran. Ran so fast that I nearly tripped over my own feet. I darted indoors, basically tossing my pooch on the couch, locking the door as fast as I could, leaning against the door, and I listened for whatever it was that chased us in. I also held the door closed, thinking it would actually do something to protect us from that thing. All I could hear was the sound of my heavy breaths from running. My dog's barking must have disturbed my family, because my mother came out of her room, saw me holding the door closed. She saw that I was distressed, wrapped her arms around me, telling me everything was okay, and asking what happened. I couldn't get the story out. For some reason, my mind told me not to tell her, because I knew that she would not believe me. So, I made up a story about how one of the neighbors startled me, and assured her that I was okay. To this day, she still does not know the story. None of my family does, and I still don't know what that creature was. But I do know one thing. It's going to haunt my mind for a very long time. The events I'm about to describe are very true, and I will take them to my grave. These events occurred around 2013 or 2014, midsummer, in a small town in rural New Hampshire. Both stories also happened with one of my friend's friend, being present at the time, and he witnessed the same things that I did. The first event that took place was on a warm summer night. My friend and I live in the same town, only about 2 miles from each other. At the time, I had my license and he did not, so I would drive out to his house, hang out, play video games, or I would pick him up and drive back to my place to hang out. Right down the hill from us and my place is this old textile mill that has been closed for a while. There have always been rumors going around about how people died working in the mill years ago. Sometimes at night, if you look in the window, apparently, you can still see ghostly figures still dressed in old-time clothing. Across the street from the mill is a dirt parking lot that telephone companies would park their work trucks in and grab them in the morning. I just picked up my friend and we were driving back to my house. As we were driving by the dirt parking lot, we noticed something. The telephone company trucks were big, and you could see underneath them, on the other side of one of the trucks. I saw a pair of legs and feet, like someone was just standing there motionless. The legs were very pale, standing out in the darkness. There were no shoes, just bare feet. It kind of looked like they were the legs of a child around 8 years old. As we kept driving and passed the truck, the feet and legs disappeared. We were going fast that there was no way if it was an actual person, they could have ran off before we passed them. I asked my friend if he saw that, thinking I was crazy. And he said, "You mean the white legs and feet?" he asked. To this day, I still hope it was our imagination playing tricks on us. And sometimes I wonder if a child may have died working in the mill many years ago, back when child labor was legal. That story is just to establish that me and this same friend can confirm with each other that we're not crazy, and we did see something otherworldly. This last event happened to me and my same friend as the ghost legs. It was late at night, and I was driving him home after coming home from the movies. Let me remind you that I live in a very rural, woodsy town. We were on this stretch of road, close to his place with woods on either side, not driving very fast. The speed limit for that road is 20 miles an hour. Just remembering this next part as I write this chills me to the absolute bone. As we're driving along, this thing flies over the road, just above the tree line. It flew next to a streetlight, which lit the creature up pretty good. At first, I just thought it was some type of bird, but as more of it appeared by the light of the streetlight, I realized this thing was way too big to be a bird of any type. The thing we saw had the body roughly the shape and size of a large wolf, but with short fur. It had bat-like wings, big enough to support its weight and size. The creature had front and back legs, unlike a bird, and also had a tail. Luckily, I didn't see it long enough to get a good description of its head, and I'm glad. I was already completely paralyzed with fear. Later on, my friend claimed that it had red eyes. The whole time this was happening, my friend and I did not say a single word. The rest of the way to his house, we said nothing. When we finally pulled his driveway, I shut off the car, and we both began freaking out. I was hoping I was going crazy, and to this day, I would think I was, but somebody saw the exact creature I did. We went on inside and told his brother he thought we were crazy, and after that long while, we told nobody because who would believe us? To this day, I don't know what kind of creature we saw that night. Just thinking about going in the woods in that town now really scares me. If anyone has any idea what we might have seen or any strange creature stories around the New England area, I would love to hear them. Thank you.